Hello everyone, I am Olivier Sanders and this is my presentation on efficient redactable signature and application to anonymous credentials. The problem we study in this paper is related to digital signature, one of the main cryptographic primitives. Digital signature can be used in practice to authenticate digital data, for example to sign several messages to ensure that not even one bit can be modified. The problem when you issue one signature for a set of messages is that you need to know all the messages to check the validity of the signature. In particular, this means that even if I need to check one specific message, I still need to know all the other ones. So let us consider a use case when one needs to verify that the user's age is over some threshold, for example, 18. Then it means that you will have to send the n other attributes of the users, which is a problem regarding efficiency because you are going to send n messages instead of one, but also regarding privacy because you are going to link a lot of information. So the problem we want to solve in this paper is how to efficiently and privately check that k out of n signed messages are certified or that they satisfy some relations. Actually, there are many other alternatives that we could use. For example, we could simply issue one signature per message. This way, when we want to check one specific message, we simply ask to send one message, which is better regarding privacy. But the problem is that now, instead of one signature, we have to store n signatures, which is a problem regarding efficiency. If we consider different solutions, such as Merkle's tree, for example, this is not significantly better because we still have to send a logarithmic number of elements even to check one element. And moreover, the use of hash function will prevent the use of efficient zero-knowledge proofs, which is a problem regarding privacy. Actually, regarding privacy, the best solution is probably to prove knowledge of all the unnecessary messages. This would be perfect regarding privacy, but the problem is that now we have replaced the sending of n messages by the sending of n proofs of knowledge of these messages. So this is far worse regarding efficiency. So there is no simple satisfying solution. But we can consider more intricate solutions from the literature. For example, Fuchsbauer et al. Proposed a system where the messages to be signed are first accumulated into an accumulator C that is signed by the issuer. This way, if one wants to check the validity of the authenticity of just a subset of these messages, for example, the birth date in my example, then one simply has to generate a witness W that this value has been accumulated in C. And by sending W, C, and sigma, the verifier is able to check this authenticity. By simply checking that the birth date has indeed been accumulated in C, and that C has been certified. This way we get a solution with a constant size for the certificate, with a constant communication complexity, if I exclude the sending of the K discrete messages, and whose verification can be performed with a complexity that only depends on the number of disclosed messages. The problem with this solution is that now the messages can be disclosed, but it is no longer possible to prove that they satisfy some relations. So this is not fully satisfying regarding privacy. Actually, there is a different solution that was proposed by Kamenisch et al. The idea is to use a new primitive that they call unlinkable redactable signature to issue one signature on the messages that have to be signed. But the point of this signature is that you can derive from it a new signature sigma prime that is only valid on a subset of these messages. For example, in my example, the signature sigma prime will only be valid on the birth date. So this means that the authenticity of the birth date can be checked by only knowing this message and the derived signature sigma prime. So here again, we have a constant size for the certificate, we have a constant communication complexity, but unfortunately in this case, the constant is very large. Moreover, this scheme suffers from the same problems as the one from the paper of Fuchsbauer et al., meaning that the messages must be disclosed, but it is not possible to efficiently prove that they satisfy some relations. So this is not a fully satisfying solution either. So in our paper, we want to improve this previous results by providing an unlinkable redactable signature scheme with short constant size signatures, and for which it is possible to verify the authenticity of k out of n messages with complexity that only depends linearly on k. Moreover, we want a system that achieves unlinkability, meaning that it is not possible to link signatures that are derived from the same signature, and we want to be able to prove relations about non-redacted messages by using zero-knowledge proofs. Our starting point will be the PS signature schemes that use asymmetric binary groups and that present very nice features. For example, the signature scheme generates signature of constant size that only consists of two elements. These signatures can be re-randomized and they can also be aggregated. Moreover, they can be verified with only one pairing equation where the messages are involved as exponents. This means that it is very easy to prove knowledge of this exponent by using standard protocols such as the Schnorr protocol. So the problem we want to solve is to check that a subset of these messages have been signed or that they satisfy some relations, meaning that we need to redact all the other messages. So the standard solution here would be to prove knowledge of the redacted messages and to reveal or prove relations about the non-redacted messages. But this would be very inefficient. So we use a different solution that is based on the following idea. If we look at the verification equation of PS signature, we can see this product that involves all the signed messages. So we could simply try to split this product into a first part that involves the redacted messages and a second part that involves the other messages. So if we aggregate the first part into an element sigma 1, we can see that we no longer need to know the redacted messages to check the authenticity of the non-redacted messages. So we could simply try to send this value sigma 1 and resulting in a new signature that would consist in three elements. But unfortunately, this signature scheme would not be secure, because the problem is that if I isolate one specific index, for example, I0 from I, we can see that it is very easy to replace the signed message MI0 by any other message. By simply aggregating the complementary part of this message into sigma 1. As you can see, the new signature sigma 1 prime, sigma tilde 1, and sigma tilde 2 would be valid on this new set of messages, meaning that the adversary could generate forgeries on any message of its choice. The problem actually is due to the fact that we can aggregate anything in sigma 1, including illicit elements. By illicit elements, I mean elements whose index is in the set I. So a first solution could be to prove that sigma 1 is well formed, but this would be bring us back to square 1. Actually, this would be a very inefficient solution. Moreover, this would be an overkill because this would prove more than what we need. We don't need to prove that sigma 1 is well formed. We just need to prove that sigma 1 does not contain illicit elements. So we will use a very different solution. Actually, if sigma 1 is honestly formed, one can see that this pairing involving sigma 1 generates a new element whose exponent is a polynomial f. And if sigma 1 has been honestly formed, then f only contains monomials of the form yi, yj for different index I and j. On the contrary, if the adversary has cheated in the construction in sigma 1, if he has aggregated illicit elements in sigma 1s, then necessarily F will contain square monomials. So to distinguish these two cases, we will simply add to the public key the element J to yi, yj for different index I and j. So these elements would be sufficient to compute a new element sigma 2 that would prove that sigma 1 is honestly formed in the former case. On the contrary, if the adversary has cheated in the construction of sigma 1, then he won't be able to prove that sigma 1 is well formed. He won't be able to compute such an element sigma 2. And this validity of sigma 1, as you can see, can be easily checked using sigma 2 by simply adding one pairing equation to our system. So this means that we get a new reductible signature scheme that consists of only four group elements. And so it is of constant size, and this signature can be verified by performing essentially K exponentiation, where K is the number of elements in I. But the problem is that right now this system is not unlinkable. So we need to improve it to achieve this property. Actually, as our signature contains a PS signature, we can simply re-randomize this part, but this would not work for sigma 1 and sigma 2. So we need to use a different approach. And actually, we will use the fact that sigma 2 does not prove that sigma 1 is well-formed. It only proves that sigma 1 does not contain illicit elements whose index is in I. So this means that we can aggregate anything else in sigma 1, including random elements. So we will, at this step, use the fact that PS signature can be aggregated. We will, in the first step, aggregate to the PS signature part of our signature. We will aggregate a random element under some dummy public key, one in our construction, but we could use anything else. And then we will re-randomize this PS signature, so we get a new PS signature that is valid on the original set of signed messages, but also on a new random element T. Then in a second step, we will redact all the messages we want to redact, and also we will redact this new randomness T. And this way, as you can see, sigma 1 prime and sigma 2 prime will include this random element T. And what we show in our paper is that this randomness will perfectly hide the redacted messages. Actually, what we show in our paper is that unlinkability now holds unconditionally. So we have a new unlinkable redactable signature scheme that is perfectly secure. And what we show in the second part of our paper is that it is very easy to construct from it a new anonymous credential system. Actually, this conversion is very simple. It consists simply in issuing a signature on the user's secret key and on his attributes. And this signature will be the credential of the user. And now the user, when he wants to show a credential on a subset of his attributes, he will simply run the derive algorithm on his secret key and on this subset of attributes to get a derived signature sigma, and it will prove knowledge of his secret key USK. So this means that the showing process of this anonymous credential would be almost as efficient as our reductible signature scheme, because we simply added a proof of knowledge of the user's secret key, which is very short. Moreover, what we show in our paper is that security of this anonymous credential system follows directly from the one of our reductible signature scheme. What we show is that if a user can cheat in the showing process, then he can forge a reductible signature. The only difference is unlinkability that no longer holds unconditionally, but that now holds under the DDH assumption. But this is very reasonable. So to conclude, in this paper, we have proposed a new efficient unlinkable reductible signature schemes. And from this signature scheme, it is possible to derive a signature on any subset of signed messages. The derived signature contains only four elements and can be verified with a complexity that depends linearly on the number of non-redacted messages. The derived signatures are unlinkable, and it is also possible to disclose the messages or to prove that they satisfy some relations, which is an important improvement over previous solutions. The downside of our paper is that now the derivation public key must contain a quadratic number of elements, but we hope that this could be improved by further work. So thank you for your attention, and do not hesitate to contact me if you have any question about my paper.